下面我们一起来看对话二。杰克到了我家，见了我父母，你得叫爸叫妈，记住了吗？记住了，你说的很容易，可是我怎么开得了口？怎么开不了口？你跟着我叫吧。记住了，爸妈，我们回来了，最近我们忙得很，现在才有空回来看你们。哦，回来了就好。我跟你妈正在商量给你们办结婚宴席的事呢。爸妈，我们已经结婚好几个月了，结婚宴席你们就别办了。再说，说什么咱们也得办，这不是在你们北京城里，这是农村。先生，您听我们慢慢说。什么？先生？你叫我先生？杰克，我是怎么跟你说的？你说记住了，怎么又忘了？叫爸，叫爸啊！老爸，杰克还不太习惯。说到我们俩结婚的事，现在得按新的办法办。您怎么还是老脑筋啊？什么叫老脑筋？这是咱们的规矩。太太，您别生气。玉兰爸，你听，他叫我太太。你得叫妈，妈，他还不懂我们的规矩。看得出来，他是不懂我们的规矩。你一个人跑到中国来，想怎么做就怎么做，你们村里的人谁也看不见。妈，您这就不明白了，他家不住在农村，他家在悉尼市里。哦，在城里，你们知道吗？结婚是一辈子的大事啊，什么都没有结婚重要。不请亲戚朋友和邻居吃饭，你们糊涂的人不说你吗？别说我们那条胡同，连我住的那一座楼里也没有人会批评我。跟您这么说吧，我们谁也不认识谁。可是我不能让村里的人说我，说我女儿。我看就这么决定了，我们去饭馆里请两个好厨师，在家里摆十几桌宴席，除了亲戚朋友以外，把村里的人也请来，大家高高兴兴地喝几杯。对。就这样了，这事由我们来办，一定得热热闹闹的办，让大家也认识认识我们家的外国姑爷。杰克到了我家，见了我父母，你得叫爸叫妈，记住了吗？记住了，你说的很容易，可是我怎么开得了口？开得了口 is the possibility compliment again. So can open up your mouth and talk means you can say it. 可是我怎么开得了口 asking however, but how can I say it? Well, he's allowed to say anything he wants, but he just feel that it is very weird to call dad and mom directly because they're just parents-in-law. And negation, 开不了口。Can't open up mouth or can't say it. 怎么开不了口？你跟着我叫吧。记住了。爸妈，我们回来了。最近我们忙得很，现在才有空回来看你们。现在才有空。So 才 is put after time adverbials means it's already pretty late. Now we have time finally, and it's already very late. That's what the speaker meant. 再看一句话，刚才在忙，现在才有空吃饭。I was busy just now, now I have time to eat, and it's already very late for meal. 哦，回来了就好。我跟你妈正在商量给你们办结婚宴席的事呢。商量的意思是 discuss before you make your decision. You're just discussing about problems and you're not making decisions. You don't use 商量, we use 讨论。你可以说我和父母商量了一下 ,I discussed with my parents before making our decisions. 爸妈，我们已经结婚好几个月了，结婚宴席你们就别办了。再说，
好几 before a classifier and its noun means several or something. It is used for approximate numbers. 比如说,好几天, 意思是 several days, 好几个月, several months, 好几年, several years. 请看一个例句, 我已经来了美国好几年了, it's been several years since I came to the States. 欧洲我们去了好几次了, we've been to Europe several times. It didn't use 过, because it's just counting the time, so they are not emphasizing they have the experience, they are emphasizing the times that they went to Europe.
说什么咱们也得办, 这不是在你们北京城里, 这是农村。
城里, you can also say 市区 means in the city, not suburban area. 市区 is more commonly used, city center,
市中心。 先生,您听我们慢慢说。
您听我们慢慢说, if you translate it, this into English literally, 您听我们, you listen to us, 慢慢说, slowly speaking. So it means you don't have to rush, there's plenty of time, and we will explain to you in details.
什么?先生? 你叫我先生? 杰克,我是怎么跟你说的? 你说记住了,怎么又忘了? 叫爸,叫爸啊! 老爸,杰克还不太习惯。 说到我们俩结婚的事,现在得按新的办法办,您怎么还是老脑筋啊?
脑筋的意思是way of thinking, 老脑筋意思是 old way of thinking, but nowadays young people would just use 老土, it means old-fashioned or old way of thinking. It's an adjective, and this is very commonly used.
什么叫老脑筋? 这是咱们的规矩。
规矩 can be rules of company, family, or according to the traditional cultural custom.
我们来看一个例句, 按规矩办事,
办事 means to deal with some events or stuff. So, do things according to rules.
按规矩办事。 太太,您别生气。 玉兰爸,你听,她叫我太太。
So mom sometimes can call dad husband, 老公, or can just say dad. Here, 玉兰爸 means 玉兰's dad.
你得叫妈? 妈,她还不懂我们的规矩。看得出来,她是不懂我们的规矩。你一个人跑到中国来,想怎么做就怎么做。你们村里的人谁也看不见。妈,您这就不明白了。 他家不住在农村,他家在悉尼市里。哦,在城里,你们知道吗?结婚是一辈子的大事啊。什么都没有结婚重要。一辈子
means one's whole life.
一辈子的大事,大事
means extremely important event during your life. And Chinese people usually say 人生大事。 It is a reference of important things that might affect the whole life, like marriage, having kids, or immigration.
比如说,结婚生子,结婚,
get married,
生子,
to have babies.
结婚生子是人生大事,
are important things in life.
不请亲戚朋友和邻居吃饭,你们胡同的人不说你吗? 别说我们那条胡同,连我住的那一座楼里也没有人会批评我。跟您这么说吧,我们谁也不认识谁。So,
Lian, what though we already learned that, but today we need to add something else.
别说A, 连B都,
or 连B也。So even B, what, and A here is impossible.
我们来看课文中的例句。 别说我们那条胡同
means our alley is impossible. You just forget about our alley because 连我住的那一座楼里 even if the building where I lived 也没有人会批评我。Nobody would criticize me, even for those people who lived in the same building with me. So just forget about the alley. Because if people from the same building are not criticizing me, then I don't need to worry about whether the people from the same alley will criticize me or not. So this is what this sentence means. 我们再来看一个例子。Let's see another example. 连 offer 都没有，别说选课了。There's no even an offer, so it's impossible to select courses because you can't even enter the college or university. So 别说 means it's even more impossible. 好，现在来练习一下，左边有三句话，请翻译成中文。And you have to remember, 别说 have to be used while translating. You don't even have enough living expenses. How can you have extra budget? So extra budget, you can just put these two after 别说 okay? 你连足够的生活费都没有，别说额外的预算了。Teachers don't even understand. How can students understand? 连老师都不懂，别说学生了。Students understand, the second understand don't have to be translated because the first one is already translated, so the second one doesn't have to be translated because they share the same event. Then even have to work on Sundays, so weekdays, of course. 连星期天都要工作， 别说工作日了。可是我不能让村里人说我女儿。我看就这么决定了，我们去饭馆里请两个好厨师，在家里摆十几桌宴席，除了亲戚朋友以外，把村里的人也请来，大家高高兴兴地喝几杯。对，就这样了，这事由我们来办，一定得热热闹闹地办，让大家也认识我们家的外国姑爷。姑爷 is a form of address for a man, used by senior members of his wife's family. So it is very unusual and it is very weird for you to say 姑爷 because nowadays young people, some of them might not know what 姑爷 means. Instead, 女婿 is more commonly used.It means son-in-law. So this one is easier and also easier to remember.
好的，那么这一本书我们就学完了。That's the end of the whole book and congratulations. 恭喜各位。我非常为你们而骄傲。So I'm really proud of you guys because after today's lesson, if you did enough revision, then you should be very fluent when it comes to intermediate in...Yeah, oral language or intermediate conversational Chinese. So I know it is a bit too much for you maybe because compared to our previous book, it is also a, it has more difficulties. But just don't worry because if you are learning more, then you can achieve more. And Chinese language is not tough.Because you can see from this book, even if we have more grammar points for you to deal with, but you will see that the sentence structure is getting more and more flexible. So sometimes the subject and the object, they go back and forth, right? 好的，那么感谢您的观看，让我们 book 4再见。See you on book 4, and I'm looking forward to studying and teaching with you again.